getting your questions answered about everything you need to know after Hurricane Ida. We are here with John Mills from FEMA. Mr. Mills, thank you once again for joining us. Appreciate your help. What is it like, so far? I know a lot of people already applied for some FEMA assistance. Can you walk us through the process and what you've seen so far since the hurricane made landfall?
Sure, Sela, and thanks for having me on. It's important to remember, and I know people are going through a lot, and there's a lot to keep track of, and people are facing a lot of stress with the power being out for as long as it's been out. So your first line of defense is your insurance. So submit your insurance claims if you have damage, homeowners insurance, renters insurance, flood insurance that's backed by FEMA, submit those insurance claims. By law, FEMA is not allowed to duplicate insurance payments. If you have serious needs, serious damage, critical needs not covered by insurance, you can also apply to FEMA for federal disaster assistance. And you can do that online at disasterassistance.gov. That's disasterassistance.gov. Or you can call us directly, call FEMA directly at 800-621-3362. It's 800-621-3362. We're already approving money for people who've contacted us. About $15 million so far, I'm told.
And so, Mr. Mills, can you clarify for us and just kind of specify what constitutes the need? I know we talked earlier about, hotel stays possibly, and that being paid for by FEMA. We have this widespread power outage. So if you have a power outage at your house and it's uncomfortable or difficult to stay at your house, can you go to a hotel? And is that something FEMA can help pay for?
A lot of people may have insurance coverage that will cover them and pay them back when they stay in a hotel in that situation. So check with your insurance provider first. If you're in a situation that you think is dangerous, if you think it's not safe to live in your home as a direct result of Hurricane Ida, and you don't know what else to do, first you can call 211 or 311 in certain locations and get various forms of assistance. Check with your local officials, listen closely to what your local officials are telling you. But then also you can contact FEMA. Let us know that you have immediate needs, serious needs, critical needs that you need help with right away. You may be able to receive some financial assistance from FEMA that'll at least help you. If you're eligible for FEMA individual assistance because you need to relocate temporarily, you may be eligible for grant money such as rental assistance. That's money that we provide you directly, usually by direct deposit, that you can use to pay for a place to rent temporarily. That include an apartment, it could include a hotel room or another situation such as that.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you. A lot of these people have no power right now, so it may be difficult right now, uncomfortable. But, doctors have told us we may be facing heat exhaustion later, heat strokes later. And so how do you kind of discern whether this is a medical emergency or a situation where you need to evacuate your home ASAP?
Apparently there's an event going on here, and I'm going to step away. And I'll continue this in another place.
Okay. I know there's a lot
Sorry about that, but they didn't tell us that the governor was going to come into that room at that particular moment. But I'm going to let Governor Edwards have the floor, and I'll stand here and continue on with you.
Oh, okay. I guess.
yes. So we've already approved a lot of money for those needs. Usually what FEMA money will provide you if you have losses not covered by insurance will be basic home repairs to make your primary residence habitable again, temporary rental assistance if you need to relocate, about 7 days of lodging reimbursement if you're eligible. So get in touch with FEMA about those needs. And we can also help survivors with other needs not covered by insurance, such as money to help replace essential personal property that was damaged or destroyed by Hurricane Ida. The other thing that we're really heavily focused on right now are life-saving and life-sustaining operations. So, for example, the city of New Orleans is opening a lot of points of distribution to get emergency food and water to people in the city who don't have power. If the city needs additional help, the city is reaching out to the state for additional commodities. If the state needs to get additional resources, the state is asking FEMA. So we're doing that all across Louisiana for all the affected parishes and local communities that need help and are making requests to the state. So when you see emergency food and water being distributed by community organizations, voluntary groups, and local cities, a lot of times FEMA is helping coordinate all of those relief efforts. In addition to that, we have multiple urban search and rescue teams working to help local first responders throughout the affected area. So they may not say FEMA on their name tags all the time, but a lot of times FEMA is coordinating a lot of those response and recovery efforts. So you may not see us all the time, but we're behind the scenes doing a lot of the coordination to support the state and all of the amazing work that Louisiana National Guard is doing and all the other state agencies, and then all the local emergency management agencies that are engaged in now. Right here, right now, I'm in Jefferson Parish in Gretna. They are working around the clock right here at the local level. If they need help, they're making that request to the state. And then if the state needs additional help with those requests, then FEMA is coming in to coordinate across the entire federal government to provide that relief the state's requesting. Hope that explains it well for you.
It sure does. I know FEMA is doing some tremendous work in partnership and coordination with the local officials and parish government leaders. So thank you so much for all your help and assistance. I think we are getting some, you know, questions in about the hotel stays again as well. And that's what I was going to just kind of go back and ask you too. You know, even if people go to these hotels or want to evacuate their homes temporarily and go somewhere cool, some of the hotels don't have power either. And some of them are saying they don't even have money to pay for an hotel up front. There are just so many logistical issues that come with this widespread power outage. What's your advice for these folks?
Yeah, so we're paying very close attention to that. And I think even at the White House level, the power company Entergy is getting some attention and some meetings. And so we're coordinating at the federal level with the Department of Energy and other federal agencies in close coordination with the state and local communities to see what the impacts of a prolonged power outage are and prepare contingency plans for what may have to be done depending on how long the power outage lasts. So all of that is in progress right now. We're optimistic that power is coming on in a lot of areas, but in particular in Metro New Orleans and some of the really hard hit areas, there are certainly some challenges there that we're very well aware of. And while we're not in charge of that, we're trying to maintain good situational awareness about what the cascading effects of a long-term power outage could be. So we're paying very close attention to that, and we're standing ready to support requests from the state we may receive.
Yeah, and so, you know, even gas is so limited and people need to travel maybe if they are, you know, going temporarily to a hotel or somewhere else. Any advice for people looking for gas as well? That's been a precious commodity people have been looking for. And the lines are tremendously long in here.
That's right. And I think that's a challenge. And right now we're focused on helping hospital systems, other critical infrastructure, first responders that are on generator power right now, so that if they need additional fuel where someone's life is at stake, then we're helping coordinate that based on requests we get from the state. And we're trying to keep emergency fuel in good supply for all the first responders and people out there saving lives and sustaining lives of all the survivors. So I would heed the advice of local officials when they tell you to stay off the roads, follow their advice. I can tell you driving around some areas in particular in Baton Rouge, a lot of the power has come back on, but there are a lot of intersections with the traffic lights still out. City of New Orleans, all the traffic lights are out. So that's incredibly dangerous. So I would follow the advice and don't go into the city of New Orleans if you absolutely don't have to, and do your best to use the resources available there and be patient because people are working hard to get everything back to normal, but it is going to take some time. Traffic is really busy on the roads elsewhere. If you don't need to use your gas, please don't. If you can work remotely at your job, do that so you don't have to be in line for gas as best as possible. I know that's not the best answer for everybody, but that's the best advice I think local officials are giving right now.
Yeah. You know, and because we're dealing with power outages, people may not even have access to Wi-Fi. Can they call the number on FEMA to get a live person on the other end to help walk them through the process and teach them how to apply for the assistance?
Yes, so you can talk to FEMA directly just by calling 800-621-3362, 800-621-3362, and tens of thousands of people have already done that, and we're speaking with them directly today. A lot of people have gotten through online on mobile devices, which is good to see, at disasterassistance.gov, so that's disasterassistance.gov, So we're happy people are also spreading the word about how to do that for people who are in Louisiana and people who have left Louisiana because of the storm. So we're getting registrations of Louisiana residents who've had damage, but they're outside the state at the moment and waiting for the word from local officials to come back.
Yeah, thank you for all you're doing, Mr. Mills. I know FEMA is on the ground. You know, there's a lot of boots on the ground trying to help people who need help, and also power crews working hard to restore power. So thank you so much, Mr. Mills, for your help. We really appreciate it. Thank you.